Hi guys, this is Sam from UberDriverNow.com. I just wanted to make a video showing you guys how to choose the navigation app in your Uber Driver app. So with the home page open right here of the Uber Driver app, you just simply tap on this account button at the bottom right hand corner, and you go to settings, and under settings there's on the very top it says navigation. Tap on that, and here are the navigation providers. So basically I have the Uber Driver navigation, built-in navigation selected, and but you can choose either Waze if you have it installed or Google Maps. But you have to have both those apps installed in your phone. And once you accept a trip and you click on the navigate, you tap on the navigate button, it's going to open up the app that you've selected here. But if it's the Uber driver, it's simply going to start navigating within the app. And before, it didn't used to be actually very, it wasn't that great, the Uber built-in navigation. So I always used to use Google Maps, but lately I've been trying the Uber driver built-in navigation, and it seems to work for me. The only option that it didn't used to have was the lane assistance that Google Maps has. When you're getting on the highway or you're making a turn on like a multi-lane intersection or multi-lane road, it will tell you which lane to be in when you're making that turn, and that really helps because of the next turn that you have to make. So and just generally, I mean, it's a very helpful feature. So now Uber driver built-in navigation also has that feature, so I use that. And there's under navigation settings, it's auto navigate. If you want, you can just turn this on, and what that does is that you don't have to click on, or you don't have to tap on the navigate button. It, as soon as you accept the trip, is going to start navigating right away. So this is a good feature as well. I just have it off because I prefer it the other way. Night mode is automatic, and distance units is also automatic, which basically means that you can select either miles and yards or kilometers. But once you have it in automatic, depending on where you live, I'm in the US, so it's automatically is going to show me as miles. So there you have it. And that is pretty much it, guys. And if you have any questions or comments, please go ahead and write them in the comment section, and like, comment, and subscribe. And a lot more helpful videos to come in the future. Safe driving, guys, and take care. See you soon.